Students, in this session we are going to explain a wonderful reaction in photochemistry. So that is Patano-Bucci reaction. So it gives a cyclic adduct whenever the carbonyl compounds react with alkene, alkyne or diene. So then we get a cyclic adduct. So the mechanism behind it is, first of all, the carbonyl compound absorbs the light radiation and N2 pi star transition takes place. So here N2 pi star transition means the compounds which are having a non-bonded electron and also pi bond, then those are called as N2 pi star transition. So by the absorption of this light radiation, N2 pi star excitation takes place. So the carbonyl compound in ground state excited to the singlet state. Singlet state means we all know about it, ground state, and this is excited state. In the ground state it is antiparallel, in the excited state also antiparallel. Whereas in triplet condition, ground state is antiparallel and excited state is parallel. That is called as triplet condition. Okay. So here the triplet excited carbonyl compound. So now after completion of this process, triplet excited carbonyl compound is ready to attack with our alkene or alkyne or diene. So then we get the product. So these are the process we actually Patano-Bucci reaction takes place. So by taking an example we explain this reaction. So here benzophenone, so react with CH2 double bond CH2. So first of all we are going to explain the reaction with alkenes. So whenever it absorbs light radiation and N2 pi star transition takes place. Okay. So I will write the product, wait a minute. So this is the reaction, these are the reactants, and the mechanism is So first of all, carbonyl compound absorbs light radiation, converted into singlet state and converting into triplet state. And the triplet excited carbonyl compound reacts with alkene. Is it right? So first of all, take our carbonyl compound pH, C double bond O pH. So this is in the ground state. By the absorption of light radiation, N2 pi star transition takes place. So that it is converted into singlet state. Okay. So for our convenience I am writing like this. So right. So what I explained before, singlet state means anti-parallel fission. So here PC, PH, PH as usual. So we have to convert the double bond, the pi bond, like this way. So this is anti-parallel, right? So this is singlet state. And then we know inter-system crossing. So singlet state is converted into triplet state. So that pH, C, O, pH. So here it is converted into triplet state. So the anti-parallel converted into parallel. So that condition is called as triplet condition. Okay. Carbonyl compound in the ground state absorbs radiation, converted into singlet. After intersystem crossing, it converted into triplet state. So, okay. So, this is our triplet excited carbonyl compound. So, take this compound pH, C, O, pH. And this react with our alkene. CH2 double bond CH2. So what happens here is, so our double bond, this is our double bond. So here it consists of two anti-parallel electrons. So here whenever these opposite fissions combine together, we get a bond. So PHCO single bond CH2, already a single bond is present, CH2 PH. So this is, so here what are remained? A clockwise notation at carbon and at this carbon. But whereas these two electrons are in the same spin, they cannot combine together. So this is known as a diradical. So upon spin inversion what happens is CH2. So any one of the electron is reversed, so that opposite spin is formed, a bond is formed. So PH, right? So this is known as oxytane. Okay? A cyclobutane ring consists of oxygen. So this is called as oxytane. So that's it, that is our end product. Okay? So this is with alkenes. And next, reaction with alkynes. So again, pH, C double bond O, pH. So alkynes means it consists of triple bond. Okay, so again, we all know about it, the triply generated carbonyl compound react with our alkene. So directly you can write the reaction. PH, C, PH, single bond O, single bond C, C4H9, so double bond C, C4H9. So here this is our pi bond. So this pi bond and this consider in the carbonyl compound, it consists of same fission. So this is clockwise and this is anti-clockwise electron joined together to give a bond. Okay, the remaining two bonds are as usual. And next one, two electrons are in balance. In the next step, they combine together COC. C4H9, double bond C, C4H9, these two combine together. Okay, so this is known as, right, PH, oxytene. Why? Because this ring consists of double bond in it. So in the previous one, it consists of all our single bonds, but whereas here it consists of a double bond here, so it is called as oxytene. It undergoes ring opening reactions. Then what happens? When these electrons form a bond in between these two carbon atoms, these electrons shifted towards this, a new bond is formed in between these two carbon atoms. So the resultant product is C double bond O C4H9, right? Single bond C C4H9, double bond C PH PH. So this is the product form. So like this way, carbonyl compounds react with alkynes. And next, with the dienes. So here, consider a carbonyl compound like this, diene. Diene means it consists of two double bonds, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. So it is known as 1,3 butadiene because 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms are there, buta, and the double bonds are present at first carbon atom and the third carbon atom. So it is called as 1,3 butadiene. Right. So here the mechanism involved in it is so first of all take our carbonyl compound by the absorption of light radiation. It gives singlet state plus our diene CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. So you can take it as triplet one because after conversion of the light radiation it is final one is a triplet state only. So whenever this react with this carbon, these electrons are shifted towards this carbon. Then what are the products formed here? So this is O, CH2, a bond is formed in between oxygen and the carbon and the electrons are shifted towards this carbon. So CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Okay, so here already then an electron is present at this carbon and an electron is present at this carbon because this is one. Okay, this carbon is this one, this carbon is this one. When the electron is shifted, it consists of a electron here. So then O CH2 single bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. So these two electrons form a bond like this way. Okay, so like this way carbonyl compounds reacts with dienes. So this is also a oxetane. So we explained various oxetane formation with alkenes, alkynes and dienes. So here so you can observe the Patton-O-Pucci reaction in intramolecular reaction, that means intramolecular Patton-O-Pucci reaction. So we all know about intramolecular. Here an alkene reacts with carbonyl compound and they are present in different compounds, but whereas if a carbonyl compound and the alkene and the double bond are present in the same molecule, then it is called as intramolecular reaction, intramolecular compound. So here it's a wonderful reaction and the yields are very good. So the example for this one is gamma or delta enones. Enones, enone means, one means ketone and en indicates double bond. So and this molecule and intramolecular Patton-O-Pucci reaction is given by gamma or delta enones. Okay, this is very most important, enones. So the efficiency of this reaction can be attributed between excited carbonyl group and ground state alkene group. Okay, so the yields are very high, usually no byproducts in this reaction. So this reaction is very efficient and it's a versatile method for the synthesis of variety of compounds that are difficult or impossible to prepare by other methods. Okay, that much of importance is there for this reaction. So here take our compound CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2, CH2 C double bond O CH3. So this is a carbonyl group and a double bond, both are present in the same molecule. So that's why it's said to be intramolecular pattern of Buchi reaction. So here alpha, beta and gamma, right? So here whenever the light radiation is absorbed by the compounds, so as we required the final product is oxetane, so we have to convert the molecule into like this way, just CH2. We are arranging the carbons only, CH, next CH2, CH2, double bond CH, single bond CH2, and next CH2, and next CH3, and next double bond O, actual double bond O, okay. So O, it consists of 2 electrons, and this pi bond is also consists of 2 electrons. So here a bond is formed in between oxygen and the CH2. Then the product is CH2, single bond CH2, CCH3O, CH, single bond CH2, right? So two electrons are remained here. One is at this carbon and another one is at this carbon. These two combine together to give CH2, CH3, O, CH2, CH, single bond CH2. So already a bond is formed in between them, a new bond is present in between them, so oxetane, right? So we explained with the alkenes, alkynes, dienes and intramolecular reaction also. So here mechanism is also explained here. And last and final one is limitations are there for the pattern of Buchi reaction. Limitations. Carbonyl group excited state should not be greater than alkene. Okay, so carbonyl group excited state should not be greater than alkene. So if, for example, if you take a norbornene, this type of questions usually asked in competitive exams also. So this is norbornene. It reacts with acetone, a carbonyl group. So the triplet excited state of this one is 74 kilocalories, whereas for norbornene is 72 kilocalories per mole. So here if you observe this, carbonyl group excited state is more than that of our alkene. Okay, so whenever carbonyl group excited state is more than alkene, pattern of Buchi reaction does not exist. Okay, carbonyl group excited state should not be greater than alkene. But here, a carbonyl excited state is greater than our alkene. So that's why pattern or it doesn't follow by pattern of which reaction. Doesn't follow pattern of which reaction. So then what happens? Norbornein dimerize together. Dimerization takes place. And give this product. A dimer is formed. Okay. So, what is our limitation? Carbonyl group. Triplet excited state of carbonyl group should not be greater than alkene. So, in this example, that happens. So, that's why it doesn't follow by pattern of which reaction. So, then what happens? It involves in dimerization. Norbornein gives it a dimer. Okay. So, like this way, we completed our pattern of which reaction. We explained in this video, we explained about reaction with alkenes, alkynes, dienes, and also with the intramolecular combination and limitations. Okay, so this is the entire video. So along with, we are providing some notes at the end of the video. Utilize this video. Thank you.